Hello.
Andreas here.
Grecian Thunder. Decided I'd try a different angle. For the Wax Diabolique. Number 22. Got a bunch to show you here, so get ready. Right now, we're listening to a little Ronnie Laws. And he's got the fever. This is on Blue Note. Had to grab it. I mean, look, he looks so damn hot and sweaty. This is a great, great record. And up next, my lady friend recommended this to me, you know. And I think I'm going to pick up the rest of these. That I could find. Bloodstains Across California. It's like a comp of early 80s punk bands. A lot of lesser known bands on here. And it's on, well, it's from 93. This is when this was put out. So, Scando Scumbag Productions. Punk. Good times. River and Shelley. Saw this in the background of some of their earlier videos, and I mistook it for a Portland band called The Bugs, when in fact it was The Bug. This is the Infected EP. It's really like really dancey. This is from 2010. I really actually like it. There's only four songs on here, but two 12 inches at 45 RPM, good dancing music. I don't know what you call it. I guess electro something. Local band. Went and saw these guys a couple weeks ago for the first time. I don't know why I've been sleeping on them, but they've been around for like almost, I want to say 13, 14 years. And they just put out a new album last year. And they have a new singer. It's a girl. Metal band by the name of Witch Mountain. And this is South of Salem. It's Doom. With the vocalist, Uta Plotkin. She sounds a lot like Ann Wilson, like, of Heart. But with, like, doom guitars and stuff, you know. Like, metal. But, yeah. So, along the same lines as, like, Blood Ceremony. But, yeah, she's a much better singer. So, if you see this out there, Mountastic Records. I don't know. If you look up Witch Mountain, and you should be able to find this record. Another metal record found used. Looking for an album by these guys for a while. Sweet Cobra. This is their album Forever from, I think, 2006. These guys are from Chicago. It's like a kind of hardcore tinged metal. A lot of breakdowns and things like that. Really gruff vocals, but you know, it's good aggro metal, I guess you'd call it. Picked up my first Moog record. Moog. I like to say Moog because it rolls off the tongue better, but yeah. You can see it's everything you always wanted to hear on the Moog. Yeah, there's Bolero. I think, Blake, you've talked about this. Carmen. Some of Carmen's on here. Really cool. I'm going to get more Moog records for sure. Scary record right here. scary good. This is it's a reissue, I think, originally from 2008. This is Sun meets Nurse with Wound, and it's called The Iron Soul of Nothing. Wow. is all I gotta say. Wow. It's a scary, scary good record. If you see it out there, pick it up. If you like Sun. Went and saw a documentary last weekend with my lady friend called Last Days Here. Those of you who have seen it know exactly what I'm talking about. But it's a documentary about Bobby Liebling, the singer of Pentagram. And I didn't have any Pentagram in my collection, so I went and got this that was put out by Relapse. Just recently reissued. This is First Days Here, the Vintage Collection. This is I think there's two volumes of this, and from what I'm told, this is the better one. And I'll probably pick up their albums eventually, but there's a ton of songs on here. It's two records, and it is on Interesting Vinyl. Whip that out real quick. Like this puppy. Man, Ronnie Law is killing it with the fever. It's hard to do from an inclined position. De-blaking. Yeah, it's a gatefold too. Yeah, and it, ironically, yeah, the movie's really good if you get a chance to see it. Please do. It's a roller coaster. It's one of those, you know, your emotions are running every direction. But ironically, it's on this, like, buttery yellow. Kind of remind me of popcorn movies, you know. So, really liked this comp. Pentagram are so rad. I first heard them, like, probably about 11, 12 years ago. But, yeah, they're fantastic, you know, pioneers of doom. Been looking for this for a while. My friend Christian, who is in Amsterdam right now, actually, turned me on to these guys a couple years ago, and I couldn't find the album, and Tony actually just showed the album that he played for me, Cross, or self-titled, I don't know. But I found Audio Video Disco. My boy Stefan73 showed this. I believe there's a few others of you that have it. I won't bore you with the gatefold. Comes with a CD, which is awesome. Pretty much, you know, if you know Justice, French duo, and basically they're the new Daft Punk, I would say. They have a different approach, of course. The vocals are really clean on this. There's more vocals on this album than there was on the Cross album. But yeah, overall, highly danceable, highly catchy, electronic music. Don't call it disco. And then finally, you knew it was coming. Oh, actually, I'm staring at this other record that I've been meaning to show. Does anybody know a Cat Burglar? Because I'd love to get the combination of this lock. This is Jack McDuff with Sophisticated Funk. Really awesome. Keyboard based. Everybody knows Jack McDuff. Well, I'm not going to say everybody. Don't you hate when people say that? Everybody knows about that. No, not everybody does. Anybody. I think Big Fred, you talked about Jack McDuff quite a bit. I know Derek has as well. Teddy, I'm pretty sure you have. But yeah, this is a Chess record from 76. This is a reissue. You know, the reissues are just as good as the originals, in my opinion. On my shitty stereo, anyway. But yeah, I mean, I was like, oh, Jack McDuff, and I started looking through the records. I saw this cover. I was like, that's the first one I'm getting. So yeah, this is rad. I'll probably pick up some more. Definitely going to pick up some more Jack McDuff. And then, I don't think I showed this in the last one. I picked it up when I went to that sale. David, Sequoia Flame, you'll appreciate this. This is a split 7-inch put out by Trendsmat Records. And it's White Hills and Acid Mother's Temple and the Cosmic Inferno doing two Hawkwind songs, which explains that cover. So really awesome to find that, and it was on sale too, and this is pretty rare, I think. So glad to have that 7-inch. And then finally, say that a million times, BAM! Dirty box set. As you know, I'm on my quest to acquire as much Sonic Youth as I can, because I love them. Again, it's a 4 LP set, if you guys that haven't know. And oh yeah, they just put this out on Record Store Day last year, this hormoning. Yeah, booklet. Oh, here's that scandalous. You guys remember that from the CD? It was on the record too. Yeah, this booklet's rad. A lot of good stories in here. 4 LPs. Get them out for you here. Those of you who know Sonic Youth know that Dirty is an awesome album. And here's the back of the box. This artist, I think this is the artist. He recently, I think he passed away recently. I think suicide, if I'm not mistaken. But the artist who did the cover for Dirty. So on here, yeah, there's just a ton of material. They did a lot of demo recording before they actually recorded the proper album. And there's some stuff on here, like their cover of Is It My Body, the Alice Cooper song. And Nick Fit is a cover. Personality Crisis is also on here. Yeah, I'm just blown away. I love Sonic Youth. I love them. I think they're one of the best bands ever. Anyway, that's number 22. It's getting a little romantic in here, so I'll let you guys soak that in, and I'll see you next time for another lovely episode of Wax Diabolique. Until next time. Nighty-night.